What's up, Knights? Welcome back to the studio.
In this week's episode, we'll take a visit to Zio Records, learn more about the voice of Higley football, and take an inside look at our school's new wakeboard and surf team.
Stay tuned because an all-new episode starts right now. Hope you all are having a great Friday. I'm Maya Griffin.
And I'm Riley Rohner.
This year, Higley is jumpstarting a new statewide wakeboard and surfing program.
Ethan and I took a trip down to the lake to find out more about the club.
Higley has so many fantastic sports teams on campus, and with one of the new additions being our very own wakeboard and surf team, we decided to get a closer look on how this brand new club came to be.
Dr. Thomason, our superintendent, to be honest, gets the credit. He has a relationship with the ownership of the Strand, the water park that's going in just a few blocks from here. And in talking with them, the idea came up to work with area high schools and start a surf and wake team. And they agreed, and we get to do it. In an ideal world, it's our hopes that it turns into the state leader in what could become a pretty cool sport.
I decided to join mainly because of my past experience, and I thought it'd be a good time to be able to work on my tricks and stuff like that, be able to put down some cool stuff.
I decided to join wakeboarding because one of my friends was doing it and she wanted me to do it with her. And it's been a really good experience so far. I like it a lot. I'm really glad I joined. So the process of a practice, usually what we do is we all get on the bus and we drive to the lake, and then we all go to the docks and they split us up onto boats.
Basically, you get in, start going out, you head towards where you can find some smooth water. Everybody gets out, starts going, they have about 10 minutes to go, and then we just switch off.
Many may be wondering, is it too late to join? Well, Mr. Dilley has the answer.
They can still join the club right now. All they have to do is see Ms. Campbell in the counselor's office. There's a fee. It's $30 for the fee. That's total for the year. That also, you know, comes with opportunities to meet. They send professional writers and all sorts of cool stuff.
I would definitely recommend this club to other Higley students because it's a super fun time and really positive environment and a great place to make new friends.
Number one, it's our hopes that it's a lot of fun. A lot of people pay a lot of money to be able to get private training and surfing and wakeboarding.
It's just a really good time with all your friends out there, being able to practice wakeboarding, which is something that not a lot of people get to do, and get to try a lot of different stuff that's fun and exciting.
Coach Lamoureux that's doing the wakeboarding is really good. Our surf coach, Coach Hunt, is a former professional surfer. You're gonna get excellent training from both of those coaches. It's a great way to meet friends who have similar interests, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. I mean, you literally get to go train in California if you're surfing. I mean, that's pretty cool.
We are excited to see what the wakeboarding team is going to be able to accomplish in the coming years. Signing off for the studio, this is Ethan and Riley.
The Knights varsity football team takes on the Coyotes tonight at Campo Verde. The game starts at 7 and the theme will be Pink Out. Be sure to come out and support the team as they continue their drive toward the playoffs.
Seniors, financial aid and FAFSA night is Thursday, October 24th from 6 to 8 in the Higley Library. Parents and students are encouraged to attend to complete the online FAFSA form. Financial aid experts will be on hand to assist and answer any questions. See Ms. Keene in the College and Career Center for more information.
The Major League Baseball playoffs are in full swing.
Andrew and Aaron decided to quiz a few students on their knowledge of the game.
Hello, Knights. The baseball playoffs have been going on since the first week of fall break. So as the baseball season comes to a close, I want to ask some baseball fans some questions to see if they're real fans or just bandwagons. All right, so today we're here with
Trevor,
Brady Fesco,
Adrian,
Rowan,
and can you tell us your favorite MLB team?
The New York Mets,
the Brewers,
the Giants,
Dodgers.
Can you tell us three players on the Mets?
We got Pete Alonso, it's pretty good, David Wright, and Bobby
Bonilla.
What are three players on the Brewers?
Ryan Braun, Christian Yelich, and Lorenzo Cain.
Bumgarner.
Muncy hits this ball to deep right field. Forget about it. Muncy with a splash hit.
Buster Posey.
Cousins is going to test him. Posey can't handle it, and Posey gets clobbered.
Brandon Crawford. Had your team ever won a World Series?
Maybe way back when. We're not too good anymore.
Yes.
Yes.
Sure. What was the Mets' record this year?
We won 86 games, so yeah, could have been worse.
I don't know.
37.
What MLB team has won 27 World Series?
27?
I'm going to go the Yankees.
The Diamondbacks?
I don't know.
Well, I guess there are some fake fans at Higley. Reporting for the studio, this is Aaron Schmidt.
AP testing payments are due October 24th, so make sure to turn in your payments into the bookstore before then. The old Kanye, straight from the gold Kanye, chop up the soul Kanye, set on his goals Kanye, I hate the new Kanye, the bad mood Kanye, the always rude Kanye, spazzing the news Kanye, I miss the sweet Kanye, chop up the beats Kanye, I gotta say, at that time I like to meet Kanye, see I invented Kanye, it wasn't any Kanye, and now I look around and there's so many Kanye's, I miss the old Kanye, straight from the gold Kanye, chop up the soul Kanye, set on his goals Kanye, I hate the new Kanye, the bad mood Kanye, the always rude Kanye, spazzing the news Kanye.
Do you have a weakness for sweets? Hayden in Phoenix recently caught up with the owner of Cinnaholic and a few student customers to get their thoughts on this local bakery.
Cinnaholic is a cinnamon roll bakery shop in Santan Village that allows you to customize your own cinnamon roll and choose your own unique toppings.
So Cinnaholic is a gourmet bakery. We specialize in cinnamon rolls, fully customizable, and we're 100% plant-based.
The different offers and meals that you can get at Cinnaholic would be your customizable meals, like for instance I got cream cheese with brownies on top and it was very delicious.
Cinnaholic not only offers you the ability to customize your own cinnamon rolls, it also gives you healthy benefits like vegan options and a great experience.
My experience at Cinnaholic was that the employees were very kind, they were very friendly, and if you haven't been there before, it's fine. They'll basically tell you everything you need to know.
You get to come into the bakery and you get to choose from 20 different frosting flavors and 20 different toppings, and it's kind of a fun thing to do.
The benefits of eating at Cinnaholic is that it's vegan, which is always a plus for everyone.
With the bakery being relatively new and with more stores popping up across the nation, it went through a lot of history to get to where it is today.
It was a bakery in Berkeley, California in 2010, and the owners actually went on Shark Tank a few years later.
The best cinnamon roll experience.
They made a deal. They ended up franchising out now.
With many other bakeries and different food stops, we asked why Cinnaholic is one to consider.
Other people should come to Cinnaholic because, I mean, it's different from your typical cinnamon place where you can just choose a variety of different toppings.
People should go to Cinnaholic because it's unique and different than anything, any other dessert shop that you've tried.
Well, there you have it, Knights. Make sure to check out Cinnaholic and grab a tasty cinnamon roll when you're in the area. This is Hayden Ashton and Phoenix McNeil reporting for The Studio.
Knights, are you ready to travel to South Korea, a place full of modern technology and traditional culture? Miss Leatherby is leading a trip there in 2021 during spring break. Come to the trip informational meeting with your parents next Tuesday, the 22nd at 6 p.m. in room 768.
Higley is hosting a band competition next Tuesday at 5:30 p.m. Come out to see the results of all the hard work our band has been putting in this year.
Come cheer on the swim team at their invite tonight at 6 p.m. at Chandler High School. Good luck, swimmers.
Today, with so much access to digital music, it's become harder and harder to fully appreciate our favorite tunes in analog form. Kennedy and I visited Zia Records to discuss the significance of their store and the cultural importance of the products they sell.
Zia Records, located in Tempe, has a wide variety of music-related products. We sat down with some employees to learn more.
Vinyl records are really important, so the fans and listeners can still have something tangible to, you know, connect themselves with this piece of music, while also supporting the artists still, since they don't really make a whole ton off of streaming.
I love physical media, and I think that's so much better, cause, like, seeing what you have.
What I think makes Zia different from all of the record stores is the overall atmosphere. Everyone here is a lot more, like, laid back, and you kind of just do your own thing.
Well, it's called Zia Record Exchange, so it's different from other record stores, because record stores like Grace Records, you can't exchange for different records or sell it back to the store to then use back and buy more records. Like, I've never been to another store that does that.
We then spoke with Evan and Mina about their favorite aspect of the job.
Being around so many creative people and being able to talk about music and movies with all the customers that come in here.
There's so many cool things. Like, I held a authentic Beatles wig in my hand once. Yeah, so I was like, never thought I would do that.
Obviously I come to Zia for the records and cassettes, but I also come for the quirky products. It's almost like Hot Topic, but I think more fun.
So the good thing about Zia is that they have a really big movie selection, and typically they're not as like common of movies or as popular now than they used to be.
Whether it be a record or a guitar, a book, a PS4, what have you, we have kind of something for everyone.
I would recommend Zia because it's just a different experience than anything, anywhere else you can go. You can exchange and use the money back in the store, go to another store, or exchange a product for a product. And they don't just have records, there's cassettes, CDs, books, movies. So I think it's really fun, and you can find things that you can't find anywhere else.
Reporting for the studio, I'm Maya Griffin.
There's a new healthy alternative to ice cream, and it's called Greek yogurt. Kylie stopped in at Culture Clash to find out more.
Hey Knights, have you been looking for a healthier alternative to frozen yogurt or ice cream? Well, recently, a new Greek yogurt shop called Culture Clash has opened in Gilbert, and it might be exactly what you're looking for. I decided to go check it out and find out for myself what makes their yogurt so good.
I started working here October 7th, I believe, is when we opened up. First work day, I come in, wash my hands, make sure everything's clean, wipe off the counters, the tables, and then when customers come in, put on gloves and ask if they want to try any yogurt. And if the yogurt runs out, we go back and make some more.
I really like it because it's a good alternative to ice cream and frozen yogurts because it's Greek yogurt.
It's healthier than frozen yogurt, and the coffee here is great. And we don't make it, a machine makes it. So if you've ever seen that before, you should definitely check that out.
A normal day, it's just pretty chill. We get like bursts of people coming in, so it's nice.
And my favorite part of working here, meeting Trevor the first time, we had a lot of fun. And we all just get along really well, and like, Alex and I, we make TikToks. We have a lot of fun, yeah.
Really like the atmosphere, lots of friendly people, everyone's really sweet.
It's different. Like, my mom was just at Water Nice and she was like, hey, Greek yogurt, like they're hiring. And I was like, Greek yogurt, like is it frozen? And I came over here, Trevor explained what it was, and it's just different and it's really good.
I would recommend this to Higley students because it's affordable, close, and delicious.
Make sure to visit Culture Clash and check out their Instagram at Culture Clash Yogurt. Reporting for the studio, I'm Kylie Pierre.
Our school has an excellent engineering program. Mike and Griffin stopped in at the 800 building to see what makes this award-winning program one of the best in the state.
The Engineering and Robotics Club allows anyone interested to join and experience hands-on work of engineering and designing robotic parts. So we went ahead and talked to Mr. Sixkiller and some of the club members about their experience in the club.
The main goal of the Engineering Robotics Club is to give students an opportunity to pursue that part of them that wants to compete, learn more, explore about not just engineering, but just STEM in general, whether it's engineering, science, even business related type competitions.
I'm the vice president. I mainly just take over if the president is not there, but I do personally help other groups a lot, like especially with their building designs. Like if there's something I see an issue with, I will point it out to them and like help them make changes to it.
Members of the club use teamwork and cooperation in order to complete the difficult tasks that come along their way.
I like to work with the robots with my partners and my team. And so I help build or like collaborate and like help the team to get to where we're supposed to be, even if we're behind.
It's just overall a like friendly environment. It's just a nice place to be.
Just everyone's goofy or fun, and you just get like team bonds and grow with each other, because personally I've worked with the same amount of people for the last like 3 years. And the same sorts of people, and you just get to know each other better. You can know like interests and how you can work and to make your project even better.
You have to be driven. You have to be able to want to learn. Things, we just don't hand things to you. A lot of the learning comes on your own, through a lot of failure. And so in order to succeed a lot of times in engineering and robotics, you're gonna fail a lot. And you have to persevere and get through that. But overall, it could be for anybody.
If you want to join the Robotics Club, check it out Thursdays after school in the 800 building. This is Griffin Small and Mike Weber reporting for The Studio.
If you already purchased your PSAT, be sure to study. The test is on October 30th and will take place from 7:25 to 11:39. Any juniors that score well are eligible to apply for the National Merit Scholarship. See the bookstore for more information.
Anyone who has attended a home varsity football game over the past 17 years has heard his voice. But how much do we really know about our Higley sports announcer? Ethan recently interviewed the man behind the microphone.
Eastmark, the number one planned community in Arizona. Eastmark is a part of something special.
There have been a lot of changes in the Higley football program over the past 17 years. One thing that hasn't changed is the distinctive voice of Joe Nuttall calling the game.
Well, I started actually in radio and TV when I was 16. Took a course at the University of Arizona in radio and television broadcasting on a summer school. After that, I went to work for a radio station in Wilcox, KWCX, as an announcer and DJ for them. You know, as far as coming to Higley, it was when my son, Mr. Nuttall, called me and said that they needed an announcer for football, and I thought that would be a great thing to do.
Announcing the game is not without its challenges.
I think one of the most challenging part of announcing is to get all the sponsors' messages across during the whole game, because fortunately there's a lot of them, and also to get all the names right. Usually come about an hour early before I'm supposed to be here. Thanks to Mr. Dilley, the athletic director, he always has a script for me of the game and when they start and things to announce and who's going to sing the national anthem. So I actually read through that every single time.
Despite the challenges, it's the positive atmosphere here at Higley that keeps Joe returning to the broadcast booth year after year.
It's really fun watching the last bastion, what I consider a pure sport, in high school football. Nobody's out there to really earn money or anything. There's playing for the love of the game. And it's really interesting to watch people do something that they want to do for the love of the game and really have fun at it. And besides, I get the best seat in the house.
Having announced the games for nearly two decades, I asked Joe about his plans going forward.
I'd like to keep doing this as long as I physically can, and Higley wants me. I'd like to put in at least to get a full 20 years here.
Students, teachers, and administrators look forward to having Joe behind the mic for years to come. Reporting for The Studio, I'm Ethan Nuttall.
Thanks for tuning in, Knights. That's all we have for you this week.
Make sure to tune in next Friday for our annual Halloween episode.
Don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Instagram at The Studio HHS. I'm feeling rough, I'm feeling wrong in the time of my life. Let's make some music, make some fun.